Hello, my name is Robin Gandhi Bandhu, here to provide a video demo for my final year project titled Student Attendance for Small Classroom, supervised by Dr. Duman with Mr. Padara posing as examiner. Before going through the demo, I will briefly explain the aims and objectives of this project. As the title suggests, the system to be developed is an automatic student attendance system which uses face recognition. The main drive behind such a system is to replace the conventional methods of attendance management, which usually makes use of sheets with your posts around the class, or roll calls among others. These methods are considered inefficient as they are time-consuming, they can be inconsistent, there can be duplication in data entry, and they can be proxies or forgery. The proposed system replaces the paperwork by automatically detecting students who are present in the class by using a class photo as input. To be able to do that, the system must be able to perform face detection and recognition. The system will make use of a user interface to facilitate user interaction and use a database to store relevant information about the students, modules enrolled, and the lecturers. The objectives of the project are to implement an automated attendance system which will resolve the problems identified with conventional methods. It should also allow student registration, where relevant details concerning the students are entered and saved in the database. These details include a name, student ID, modules enrolled, and a face image to be used for comparison and matching. As I said before, the system takes class photo as input, on which face detection and feature extraction is carried out. The extracted features are then compared to those from the face images in the database. Each successful match means that a student is present. From that, the records in the database are automatically updated, and a corresponding attendance sheet is created, listing the module taught, the date time, and the students marked either as present or absent. Now, onto the demo with the final program where the user interface, database, and other functionalities have been implemented. The system can only be accessed by authorized users, thus the need for a login feature. The system will show an error message for invalid credentials input. It will also show a warning message in case the username or password fields are left empty. And in case of, and when the correct credentials have been input, a success message is displayed. Upon successful login, it will display the menu allowing the user to choose what to do next. So from here, the user is allowed to log out immediately and will be redirected to the login screen. Now, before actually generating an attendance, we first need to register the student. From here, the relevant details can be entered and be stored in the database, especially the face image, which will be used to do comparison and matching with the class photo, with the detected faces in the class photo. This method is used to allow for late registration of students, as opposed to a training method, where a model will have to be retrained for each new student. So here, when the details have been provided, the user can click on register to save the student details or go back to the main menu. So here, as in the login screen, a warning message is displayed in case one or more fields are left empty. So here, if you click on register, a warning message is displayed. So then the user is then allowed to enter. And here the user will be able to upload a student face image either by using a webcam, if it is available, as it is quite handy, or by taking a photo using a mobile phone or any digital camera, and connecting the device to the computer and browsing and selecting the photo. Press on the spacebar to capture an image and press on the escape key to close the webcam window. So here, an image is taken and the captured image will be displayed here. Now that all the details have been provided, we can click on the register button. There are some checks before the registration that I need to show first. So starting with the student ID. Since the student ID is unique to each student, a check is carried out on the already registered students to see if he or she already exists. So here, this student ID already exists in the database here. So if I click on register, it shows a student already registered error. So I'll just do another. If there's no detected faces, it will show an error, so no face detected. So instead, we can choose another one, for example this, and it will show registration successful if a face is detected and all the details have been provided. And to show the database and entry, the ID was demo 888 and the face input is here. When students have been registered, we can perform face recognition on the class photo and generate an attendance. So here, as in the previous screens, the user can go back to the main menu by clicking on the back button and can generate an attendance by generating the attendance photo. And same as in the registration screen, the user can browse and select a photo. So here the webcam option is not provided. As we close photo, the clarity of the image will be lower using a webcam as opposed to using a digital camera or even a mobile phone camera. And the same check is applied as in the registration screen, that is, if no information is provided, it will show a warning. So from here we can browse the photo. For example, this has there are six faces here. So before showing the attendance, before generating the attendance, the system keeps track of who is logged in. That is, a logged in user, that is a lecturer, will have a module that he or she teaches. And that module will have a list of students enrolled. So to sum it up, the system loads that list of students enrolled in the module taught by the logged in lecturer. So the system then compares the detected faces in the photo here to the face images from the student list, not the whole list of students in the database, and then marks the identified ones as present and the rest as absent. The information is then saved in the database and the corresponding attendance sheet is generated. So to show an attendance sheet, I already registered some students in some modules. So then it will generate an attendance sheet. It will take a few moments depending on the image quality. So here it is a high quality image and the number of faces to compare. So first it shows an image with detected and identified faces, just so the lecturer can then cross-check if there are any errors, and then a corresponding attendance sheet is generated. So the logged-in lecturer teaches this module here, the date is shown here, the detected faces, so there were six faces in the input photo. There are only four that have been identified. and two unknown. This means that out of the six, only these four are present, and these two unknown persons are not enrolled in that module, which is why they are clarified as unknown, because their faces have not been compared to that list of students enrolled in that module. So we can see the ID here, and in the list there, here, and the omboka's present. Now to show another example, and load another list of students enrolled in that module. So I will use another. Given the second circumstances due to the pandemic and the lockdown in March, I wasn't able to perform more testing in a classroom. I have instead used group photos of my classmates and some celebrity group photos to test the system capabilities. This photo is not the best one, as it becomes pixelated when zoomed in, or pixelated again when it is cropped for face detection. But the system is still able to work with it and perform face detection and recognition, and will perform better with an appropriate cross photo. So here we can generate another attendance sheet, which will load another list based on the new login user. So this one will take some time, as there are more faces to compare, and I believe there are more students in the list of students enrolling that module. In the meantime, I can also show the attendance that has been saved in the database. So here you can see these are the ones. It was 1806. So as from here, this is the list of all the students that I have just tested before. So here it shows that zero shows that you're absent, and one shows that you have been present. So one here is present, and another one present here. So to show the final test here, we can see the detected faces and the student IDs here. Now, this particular face has not been detected because it's not a frontal face. Then a corresponding attendance sheet is created. So the other one was computer vision, this one is capacity planning, and there are more students in this one. So to speed up the process of this demo, I already registered other students and used some celebrity face pictures, which I used for testing earlier. So here it detects 28 students, where in fact there are 29 because this one has been detected, and the identified faces are 6, which means that in this photo there are only 6 students that are enrolled in the module taught by the loading lecturer, and the rest are not in that list of students. So you can see all the real student ID or MOOC that's present except this one. I have just another face image using that ID, which is why. And to show the records in the database, here, down to here, it shows the students marked either as present or absent. So you can see here, we have This list of mockups present same as in the attendance sheet, and all the rest of them are mockups absent because they are not part of this picture. Set at the start were met, and the system is able to perform attendance management where the details are stored in the database by using. You can perform attendance by using the face images of the students, which are stored here, for example. Some of the students here and here. And the details are stored in the database. The a corresponding attendance sheet is created. With the details up here, module up here. So in fact I can conclude that the objectives have been met. Thank you for watching.